The Great Gospel of John, Book 8, Chapter 185. The First Two Kinds of Fire of Purification. Then the innkeeper, the father of Caddo, stood up and said, O Lord and Master, then how will it look like in the time of which you have said that the people will then be purified by fire before your return, and what kind of fire will it then be? I said, Yes, friend, that fire will be great and general need, distress, misery and sadness, of a greater magnitude than the earth has ever seen. Faith will extinguish and love will cool off, and all poor races will lament and languish, but still, the great and mighty and the kings of this world will not help the supplicants because of their great pride and by that also because of a too great hardness of their heart. So also, one people will rise up against another and will attack them with weapons of fire. Because of that, the rulers will come into great debts that cannot be paid off and will afflict their citizens with unaffordable high taxes. Because of that, there will be an excessive high cost of living, famine, many malicious diseases and epidemics and pestilence among the people, the animals, and even the plants. There will also be heavy storms on the mainland and on sea, and earthquakes, and the sea will flood its shores in many places, and then the people will come into great fear and anguish because of the expectation of the things which will then come over the earth. All this will be allowed in order to turn the people away from their pride and their selfishness and their great laziness. The great and those who think of themselves to be mighty will be chastised with boredom and will by that be forced to come into action to free themselves from this torment. And look, this is the first kind of fire by which the people will be purified for my return. And in that same time, also the natural fire will play an extremely important role. The fire will drive on the ships over all the seas with a speed greater than that of the wind. Also, men will make with their sharp intellect iron cars and roads, and instead of pack animals they will harness fire to the cars, and with its great power they will drive off far over the earth, faster than an arrow that has been shot off. In this manner they also will be able to control the lightning one and make it the fastest transmitter of their wishes and will from one extreme of the earth to the other. And if they, the proud and greedy kings, will war against each other, the fire will render a great and decisive service, for by its great power, iron masses in the form of a sphere with a heavy weight will be flung with the speed of lightning to the enemy, the cities and strongholds and cause great destructions. With these weapons the inventive people will come to the point when soon no nation will be able to start a war against the other, for when two nations should attack each other with such weapons then they easily and quickly will exterminate each other up to the last person, which would certainly not give a true victory and gain for neither one of them. Those kings and their generals will soon realize that, and that is why they will rather tolerate each other in peace and good friendship. And if somewhere a very proud and ambitious disturber of the peace should rise and would attack his neighbor, then the peaceful ones will unite themselves and chastise him. And in this way the ancient peace will be set for the people on earth and will be established durably. If one will count, from this my actual presence, almost 1800 and almost 90 years, there will hardly be any more war on earth, and more or less in that time, also my personal coming on this earth will take place, and the greatest enlightenment of men will begin. Although there still will be wars among the more primitive peoples of the earth, but these will also soon become impossible among them. I will drive them together with the help of my righteous and mighty kings and generals and let them pour out my light among them, and then they also will be changed into peaceful nations dedicated to the light. Look, this is the second kind of fire by which the people will be purified. The Great Gospel of John, Book 8, Chapter 186. The Third and Fourth Fires of Purification. A third kind of fire will consist in the fact that I will awake already a few 100 years earlier ever clearer enlightened seers, prophets and helpers who will in my name, just as clear and truthful, teach the peoples everywhere about everything and will thus free them from all kinds of lies and deceit, which through false prophets and priests, even in my name, will clear the way for their downfall, and with that they will start, in a not too distant future, their evil beginning, and here and there they already have started it in my present time. They will, just like the other pagan priests, perform false signs and wonders and will deceive many people by which they will provide themselves with great earthly treasures, riches, might and great prestige, but by the third fire and its most bright light they will lose everything and go completely to ruin. And the kings and princes who want to help them will by that lose all their might, their wealth and their thrones. For I will awaken my kings and generals against them and will give them the victory, and so the ancient night of hell and its messengers among the people on earth will come to an end. As this night now consists in the pagan, blind and useless ceremony, which they call divine service, it will also exist in those times, but by the third kind of fire from the heavens it will be entirely devastated and annihilated because the lie will not be able to stand victorious in the battle with the light of the truth from the heavens, as less as the natural night can stand before the risen sun. It must flee in its most dark holes and depths, and those who stand in the light will search no more for the night. I have shown you now the third kind of fire that has an extremely destroying effect on the darkness of men, and so I also will show you a fourth kind of fire by which the earth, the people and all creatures will have to be purified by my second coming. This kind of fire will consist of all kinds of great natural upheavals of the earth. More precisely on those places of the earth where men have built two big and beautiful cities in which the greatest pride, lack of love, bad morals, false administration of justice, power, prestige, laziness and with that also the greatest poverty and all kinds of need and misery will prevail, caused by a too strongly grown out epicurism of the great and mighty. In such cities, through excessive pursuit of profit, all kinds of factories will be built on a large scale, and instead of human hands the work will be done by fire and water, together with thousands kind of artful machines that are made of metal. The heating will be done by means of the ancient coals of the earth that men will acquire in extremely great quantities from the depths of the earth. Once such activity will have attained its highest point by the force of the fire, the air of the earth will become too strongly saturated on such places of the earth with combustible kinds of ether, and these will soon ignite here and there and transform such cities and regions together with their many inhabitants into ruins and ashes, and that will then also be a great and effective purification. But whatever the produced fire will not have accomplished, that all kinds of great storms on earth will accomplish, obviously only though where this will be necessary, for without necessity nothing will be burned or destroyed. By that, also the air on the earth will be freed from its bad vapors and nature spirits, which will have a blissful influence on all other creatures on earth and which will also benefit the physical health of the people, because the many malicious bodily diseases will cease to exist and the people will be able to reach a healthy, strong and old age. Because the thus purified people will be standing in my light and will lively and truly keep forever the commandments of love from within, the earthly landed property will also be divided among the people in such a way that everyone will have so much that, with the right kind of zeal, he never will have to suffer need. The heads of the communities and also the kings, being entirely submitted to my will and standing in my light, will take care that there will never exist any need among the people. And I myself will once here then again visit the people and strengthen and establish them in those places where the people will have the strongest desire for me and possess the greatest love for me. And with this you have received now for you Greeks a very understandable answer to your question. Although it is a prediction for a still quite far away future, but it will not remain unfulfilled, for everything can perish sooner, even this earth and the whole visible sky, rather than that one of my words and predictions would remain unfulfilled. Did you well understand this now? Isaiah 24 verse 17 to 22. Terror and the pit and the snare are upon you, O inhabitant of the earth. He who flees at the sound of the terror shall fall into the pit, and he who climbs out of the pit shall be caught in the snare. For the windows of heaven are opened, and the foundations of the earth tremble. The earth is utterly broken, the earth is split apart, the earth is violently shaken. The earth staggers like a drunken man, it sways like a hut, its transgression lies heavy upon it, and it falls, and will not rise again. On that day the Lord will punish the host of heaven, in heaven, and the kings of the earth, on the earth. They will be gathered together as prisoners in a pit, they will be shut up in a prison, and after many days they will be punished. Heavenly Gifts, Volume 3, Chapter 48, Verse 1 to 17. Judgment of Unkindness. So write how it is now and will be. Now is only the real beginning. I have given the nations, all the great, the powerful and the rich, and all the merchants, artists and trade unionists sufficient time and leisure for improvement through the manifold signs, such as the small popular uprisings, smaller wars, through 1,000 petitions, posters and all kinds of magazines, also through epidemics, local famines, through lack of money and labor and also through hailstorms and floods. Thus I have also caused some kings and princes who were too greedy and domineering to be humiliated beyond measure by the people. I have ordered imperial diets and torn up the many stupid letters of nobility, I have wielded a sharp rod over the whore and had her servants flogged in great heaps. Who would think, with all these more than palpable signs, that they will not have recognized and understood where these signs come from, so that one might turn to me on all sides and receive from me grace, mercy and salvation from all the evils to come through true repentance and earnest prayers and through a right conversion to my word, which is written in the book of the New Testament. Salvation from all the evils to come? But behold, of all this there is no trace. The great and the mighty now seek counsel from hell and want to re-establish themselves on their old thrones by artificially excited civil wars. But I say there will be nothing of it, for their kingdom of lust, lechery and fornication is at an end. For they have now all ruled more for the sake of great lust, lechery and the most shameful fornication, and made the poor nations the most oppressed camp of shame for their fornication, and for the sake of a whore thousands and thousands more must sacrifice their blood and lives. Therefore, curse and eternal shame to such rulers of the nations. They shall be blown away like chaff. The rich, the artists, the merchants, factory owners, and the wealthy trade unionists, among whom are to be understood all landowners, large owners of real estates and or owners, I have brought thousands of poor people. But, instead of receiving them with soft, compassionate hearts, they were turned away from the doors with sword and fire. This cries out to me for vengeance, and I will take it to 100 and 1,000 times over. For as many guilders as they withheld from the poor, since they could easily have given them such a little something from their great abundance, they will now forfeit just as many hundreds or thousands by force. Blessed are those who have not closed their hearts to their poor brothers, who will find a safe asylum under my hands even in the highest storms. But whoever wants to forfeit and lose all his fortune and lose all his wealth, let him now begin to be hard and frugal. Verily, before the moon shall change its light 7 times, he shall be stripped of all his wealth and stand there like a beggar, supported by the weak and frail staff of despair on all sides. Take heed now, ye great, mighty, rich, artists and merchants, your time is come. For your measure, your shameful measure has become full of all kinds of fornication, lewdness, gluttony, lordliness, hatred, avarice, envy, hardness of heart, unmercifulness, and fullest unkindness. But I will and will therefore also send you a judgment on your proud heads, the like of which the earth has not yet tasted, because faith in me and love for me and your brothers has so completely and utterly vanished from your hearts. The fiercest general war, on top of it and hunger, pestilence and fire from heaven will thus blow away and consume you as if you had never been there. In a few years your names will never be found, for you will be struck from the great book of life by this greatest judgment which you have well deserved. Verily, no butcher deals more ruthlessly and mercilessly with his slaughtered cattle than the nations will deal with you, because you did not want to recognize my warning, and even in these days of great misery of the poor brethren, which you have caused them, you only sought to increase their misery instead of decreasing it. You, who count your fortune by hundreds of thousands, certainly do not know the misery of one who has not had a penny in his poor pocket for days, but in the future you shall know it 100-fold. You rich spendthrift, who out of sheer with what the finest and most expensive delicacies you should feed your wretched flesh, in order to make it all the more voluptuous and more suitable for the wooers, while 1,000 of your poor brethren, whom you call common beasts and canailers, have barely enough of the coarsest, barely edible bread to satisfy their burning hunger. O wretched, most insensate, rich reveller, who hardly know how to help yourself with bacon and fat, your stomach does not know how it is with one who is always hungry. But you will know in the future. But 100-fold woe to you most insensitive servants of the great whore. I will and will strike you on the head, because even in this time you do not want to recognize me and you only lull the people out of your most shameful lust for power and greed against those who are placed to maintain the outward order and against the true confessors of my word, you shall be judged most severely. For I myself shall now give to the nations crown and scepter and sword, and they shall sweep you out like a windmill the chaff from the wheat, and I will no longer listen to your nonsensical cawing and will let you perish without distinction. But rejoice, you few believers and you charitable ones in my name, especially in this time, for a beautiful fate awaits you, if you will remain with me in these days of great temptation. For after this no more temptation and trial shall afflict you no more. Amen. These things saith the first and the last, who now wieldeth the sword of righteousness, and of fire, and of death. Amen, amen, amen. Announcement of the signs of the end times through the Lord. Selected quotes from the Revelation of God to Jakob Lorber, 1800-1864, on the end times. To the enemy from the skies, the general judgment. End and new banishment. Heaven Gifts Volume 3. But before I, as the Lord and Creator of all life, can come again, the ground must be finally cleansed of all weeds, and this cleansing is going on right now on all points of the earth. Whoever, then, is knowingly sick in his soul and does not seek that his soul be healed, will not long perish. But the time of purification will last 4 weeks at the shortest, for there will now be hours in which more will be done will happen than in a century. A longer term is set at 4 months, for there will now be days, one of which will mean more than in former times a full century. Yet another deadline is set at 4 quarters, for more will now happen in 1 week than in the 4 time in a fullest century. And still another farthest date is set at 4 years, and still another small thing of the time added, for there will now come moons in which more will happen than in the 4 time in 7 centuries. The Great Gospel of John, Book 6, Chapter 174. But all this must take place about 700 years before the judgment, so that in the end nobody can say that he was not warned sufficiently. From now not fully 2,000 years will pass, and this will be apparently a youngest but at the same time also last judgment on this earth. Some 5 years and 5 months. The Great Gospel of John, Book 5, Chapter 108. 200 years before the end announcement of the truth by awakened, the enemy from the skies. But in the end there will come a time when the people will achieve a great knowledge and skill in all things and will build all sorts of machines which will perform all human tasks just like living, thinking people and animals. But through this many people will become unemployed, and the stomachs of the poor, jobless people will go hungry. Then the misery of man will increase to an unbelievably high level. Immediately then people will be awakened by me once again, and they will announce the truth of my name for more than 200 years. Things will be well for those who then turn towards it, although their number will be only a small one. However, once the number of the pure and good will have dwindled as in the time of Noah, the earth will again be visited with a universal judgment in which neither people nor animals or plants will be spared. No longer will their lethal, the fire-spitting weapons be of any use to the proud people, nor their fortifications and metal roads on which they will move along with the speed of an arrow. For there will come an enemy from the air and destroy all those who have always done evil. This will truly be a time of shopkeepers and money changers. What I did only recently in the temple at Jerusalem to the money changers and pigeon sellers, I shall do on a large scale all over the earth and destroy all the selling and money-changing stalls through the enemy whom I shall send to the earth from the vast expanses of the air like a flash of lightning and with a great thunderous noise. Truly, against that one all the armies of the earth will fight in vain. However, the great, invincible enemy will not harm my few friends but will spare them for a new plant nursery which will produce new and better people. Do understand this well. But do by no means think that I want it thus and that therefore all this is predestined. Nothing could be further from me and from you. Yet it will be as it was before the time of Noah. The people will keep putting their worldly knowledge and acquired skills to increasingly evil use and, of their own free will, bring upon themselves and, finally, upon the whole earth, all kinds of judgment out of the depths of my creation. But then I will say along with you, my noble Romans, Volenti non fit in iria, the willing is not wronged. Yes. The people shall indeed have everything in meets and bounds, build their earthly lives in comfort and shall spare their hands from hard work, in order to gain all the more time for the development and ennoblement of their hearts and souls, and shall all immediately be full of joy in my name throughout all their lives. But among them there shall be no suffering or grieving people, except a willful sinner against every well-established order in my name. But if along with the naturally increasing skill of the people their selfishness, greed and power grab also increase and thus the darkening of the human minds, then naturally bad consequences can also not be avoided. For if you quickly put one foot after the other again and again, the result of this fast procedure cannot be avoided. But whoever hesitates with his foot cannot complain if even a snail overtakes him. Falling from a great height obviously brings death to the body, but if someone knows this from experience and jumps nonetheless from a great height into the depths, what is that called? Behold, that is blind wantonness, and the terrible consequence of this is not my will, but instead the unchanging law of my eternal order, which cannot be lifted either in a particular place or even less in general. Or do you think that I should therefore take the destructive heat from the fire so that an idiot who throws himself into the fire should suffer no harm? Or should I take away from the water what makes it water and that a person can drown in it either through lack of care or by being pushed by someone or by own intent? The Great Gospel of John, Book 6, Chapter 150. From now on for nearly 2,000 years countless many seers and prophets will be awakened, while at the same time even a bigger number of false prophets and even highly haughty, power-hungry and all love-bear false Christs will rise. But also the judgments will continue and there will seldom be a ruler who because of his darkness will not together with his people, have to endure a severe judgment. Towards the end of the indicated period, I will awaken even bigger prophets and with them also the judgments will increase and become more widespread. There will occur great earthquakes and very destructible storms of elements, large price increases, wars, famine, pestilence and many other disasters, and as I have already remarked earlier, faith will, except for a very few, not be among the people, and will be frozen in the ice of the people's haughtiness, and one nation will attack the other. The people will be warned through seers and special signs in the sky, of which only a few of mine will take note of, while the world people will only regard this as effects of nature and spit on those who still believe in me. Thereupon the greatest revelation through my repeated return to this earth will take place. But this revelation will already be preempted by the greatest and sharpest judgment and be followed by a general thinning of the world people through fire and its projectiles, so that I myself can establish a completely different plant school for true people on this earth. which then will last until the end of times of this earth. I now say this to you in advance, that you certainly should not be of the opinion that after me it will be perfect like in my heavens. Yes, very few will be equal to my angels, but many even a lot worse than are the people during these our times.